signal strength.
Wow, can you remember, Kavir and I were standing in here just going down memory lane. That was how we used to end the broadcast day. Really funny. Well, today is the end of another era in broadcasting.
Can you believe that? That
no.
is how, I mean, you used to have three channels.
Right.
And at the end of the day, you'd go to snow, you'd have the bar, color
yeah.
bars, the national anthem. Wow, made me feel really young. But today, as Allison said, we're ending analog television. That's the way we've always broadcast things here. And we're switching from analog to digital. There are a lot of people out there, though, that still have just a lot of questions about what's going to happen here. A lot of people are not ready for this big digital switch. Well, we have our experts in studio to answer your questions with a live phone bank. That phone bank is going to be running until 11:30 tonight. Dial the number that's on your screen, 202-895-3307.
Now, for those of you who are ready, it may not seem like much of a change, but the way that your TV is getting its picture will be forever different. Channel 5, D.C.'s first television station, went on the air back in 1945, downtown on the 10th floor of the Hotel Harrington. We broadcasted picture and sound from this tiny antenna on the hotel roof. Obviously, things have changed a great deal since then, as we now look at our 5 seconds left.
All right, count it down.
Go ahead and order your coupons from them.
There you go.
About 3 weeks for them to ship that coupon.
Yeah.
All right, you take care.
Bye-bye. There you go. He's about to flip that switch, and I think he just did it. All right, well, hopefully you can still see us.
That's
and,
right.
Right, and if you can't, you're probably going to get a message very shortly, and it's going to tell you what you need to do to be able to see us in the future and the rest of your program.
All right. Have a good day. We'll join Tyra in progress. See ya.
How much you love this man. Has that changed?
In HD from today's TMJ4.
This is Live at Noon.
Well, if you are not hooked up for digital television, you're about to find out. An historic moment is upon us here at today's TMJ4. In just a few moments, we'll discontinue programming on our analog signal. Today's TMJ4, like every television station in the country, will be shutting down our old transmitter. We'll hit the switch in about 2 or 3 minutes. Here's the guy helping us make that switch. His name is George Kasdorf. He's a retired engineer from today's TMJ4
right.
who
you.
Helped put this television station on the air for the first time. That was way back in 1947. Mr. Kasdorf has temporarily come out of retirement to help us in this historic moment. And if you're not ready for the switch, you're going to know. If your television is not equipped to handle our digital signal, you'll lose this program, and you'll see a graphic with some telephone numbers to call for help. These folks at our studios here on Capitol Drive are ready to take your calls. Our phone bank is up and running and will remain so today until 7 o'clock. As I referenced earlier, WTMJ Television first fired up the transmitter and began broadcasting in 1947. A lot of things have happened around here since then, and it's been our goal and our duty to bring those events into your homes. You may recognize some of these faces from this news open that debuted in 1982, but we went on air long before that. We experimented with a closed-circuit TV station back in the 1930s, but then World War II stopped the production of TVs. On December 3rd, 1947, our transmitter went on the air for the first time. Over the years, we've covered historic news events. The politically charged Milwaukee 14, the riots of 1967. We've also covered Wisconsin sports from the beginning. The beloved Milwaukee Braves. Perhaps less memorable, but, well, certainly interesting. Something we dug up called table bowling. We also produced a variety of shows over the years, including something called Hot Shot. And who out there remembers when Samson the Gorilla was just a baby? color TV, stereo TV, HD TV, extraordinary advances in the technology of television over the years, and the digital revolution is upon us. For this historic moment, we send it into our master control center, and Scott Steele is standing by there. Scott, with our special guest.
Vinny, I'll tell you what, this is truly historic, and rarely in life do you get an opportunity to witness up close what is truly a historic moment, and that's what's going to happen right here in just a few minutes. You know, we have been undergoing a massive change, a massive upgrade in operations here throughout Journal Communications, and you are right now looking at master control operations where everything has been converted in the last 12 months or more to digital television, which is a better signal and will be able to provide you higher quality broadcasts. But the man who remembers what it was like in the beginning, remember all that fuzzy stuff with ghosts and things on your screen? George Kasdorf. He was the second engineer hired back in 1947. And we went on the air December 3rd of that same year. So right. Just less than a month later, you remember the switch being flipped?
Yes, I remember the day. Yeah, day our mic boom came in. And so I worked all day putting it together, and so we used it that evening for the ceremonies.
What was it like back in those days? We'll look at some pictures in a moment from your album that you brought in, but it was fascinating to see. Everything was bigger, that's for sure.
Oh, yes, and it was made like military equipment. You know, they were suitcases, you know, although they were kind of heavy with the big transformers and the tubes and everything. And we'd started out... after we got on the air, like on Thursday, it was wrestling night. So we had a program in the a lobby at about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and maybe 3:30, we'd haul that camera, and we had two cameras, and we'd haul that out to a truck. We didn't have a remote truck either.
And George, you know what? We'll talk more about that in a moment, but we've got just about 30 seconds until we're going to make that switch. I'd like to have you come right over here, walk right in front of me, and you're going to be pressing the button over here. You know what you're going to be doing?
Oh, yes.
Have they given you the rehearsal?
I rehearsed.
All right, here we go. Let's have the countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And look at that, we have gone from analog and digital to now exclusively a digital signal here throughout southeastern Wisconsin, a historic moment. George, we'll talk more with you in just a second, but I'd like to bring in Steve Wexler, the leader of this operation here at today's TMJ4 and